Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another video. Today we are continuing and probably finishing our quest through the MLB position field. We are going to be ranking every MLB starting ace pitcher. Now there are two pitchers from each team on this list. It's just the best one I could find. So yeah, we're going to be ranking them tier list style. If you guys do enjoy, remember to leave a like as well as subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. I truly would appreciate it. Check out the podcast Hardball Hangout, linked in the description, as well as all my other socials. That being said, let's get right into the video. All right, to start, going through the tiers, you already know it. Elite, above average, average, below average, and trash. I will say this, I know it's not going to be great to put trash, because none of these guys realistically are trash pitchers in the MLB. Well, maybe a couple, but like, we're going to be basing it on like this list particularly, which is really what we've been doing for all of these. Starting off with Zach Gallen, a very, very solid pitcher for the Arizona Diamondbacks. Honestly, right now, has kind of put himself into an above average starting pitcher in the MLB. A low 3s ERA, a whip that hangs just around 1, guy who does not walk a lot of batters, very good pitcher. Madison Bumgarner, just not great anymore, used to be great. Right now, I don't know if I even can call him serviceable, but probably average. Max Fried, now here's the deal. Elite is the top 5 pitchers in baseball. Do I think Max Fried is there? No. Do I think he's darn close? Yes, he is very good. Same really as Gallen, just a low 3s ERA, a whip that hangs right around 1. Ian Anderson, on the grand scheme of things, he's below average. Really disappointing this year. Last year he was okay. This year he's been injured and he's not been good when he's not injured, so just not very good. John Means, on this list, he is average. Very, very serviceable for the type of guy that the Orioles need. I know he's injured right now, I believe, or he was injured at one point, but kind of the perfect guy for the Orioles. Jordan Lyles, very, very similar. He kind of probably falls more toward below average, though, just because he's not as good as them, and he's right around the same level as Anderson. Chris Sale. Now, this one's really tough, because Chris Sale has been injured a lot the past couple of years, and he's injured again, just injured himself again. And when he's not hurt, yes, he is phenomenal, but his lack of health, I don't even like know what I can do. Like, it's just kind of tough. Nathan Eovaldi, another guy who is injured, but when he is healthy, he is very good. Honestly, an above average pitcher when healthy. But unlike Sale, he actually has been healthy the last couple years. Right now, he's just not. Marcus Stroman. This year, he's not been great, and in past years, he's been just like it. 2021 was kind of just like the outlier, so he's average. Kyle Hendricks, another guy who is serviceable, and just the same thing, kind of like Bumgarner. Luis Castillo, wow. Just got dealt to the Mariners today, by the way. So, yeah, rest in peace. Oh, is he one of the best 5? He's darn close. He's really close. We'll see what it is, but he's above average for now. This is Hunter Green, I believe, just right now. No, I mean, he's just so young. Shane Bieber. Wow. Oh, man, this is tough. Above average. He's so good. He is. 2020 was not a fluke. He's so similar to Max Fried, actually. Very, very similar numbers between Max Fried and Shane Bieber. Zach Plesac, a guy who is very, very serviceable, very good as the number 2 or even number 3 now with Tristan McKenzie up and rising on the Guardians rotation. German Marquez, his numbers just have not been great the past couple of seasons. He pitches in Coors, I get it, and he has had years where he's been great, but right now, average. Kyle Freeland. This is a guy who right now is overpaid. He got an extension early on this year. And, I mean, he's just okay. When Lance Lynn is healthy, he is very good. And he's probably an above average right now. Lucas Giolito. Okay. Has been very good at times. This year, he's struggling, though. He's probably average. Eduardo Rodriguez. Another guy who just has numbers that hang right around these guys right here. Tariq Skubal. Actually, what are his numbers this year? Because I know that he's, like, a really big free agent like target right now. This year, 3.67 ERA. That's actually not bad at all. Had one bad day here, but other than that, not bad. Nah. Justin Verlander, the first to go into the elite. Dude, he's so old and he's so good. It doesn't make any sense to me. Framber Valdez. Ooh. Oh, man. Oh, man. You know, I really, really want to put Framber into elite, but hold up. 2.74. Easy, dude. Dude, he is unbelievable. Zach Greinke, just not it anymore. I'm sorry. I think this is Brad Keller, another guy who just not great anymore. Shohei Ohtani. Okay. The hitter, we know he's elite, and that says a designated hitter. As a pitcher, though, I don't know. This year, Shohei is posting an ERA of 2.81 through how many starts? 9-6, by the way, and 17 starts. Those are elite-type numbers. Noah Syndergaard, another guy who just doesn't really have it much anymore. Arguably could go into average because he is kind of serviceable, but eh. Walker Buehler, when healthy, he's great. Is he one of the best five? I don't think so. Right toward the top of average. Kershaw, the same exact thing. Kershaw is definitely a little bit worse now, but he still is really good. Sandy Alcantara. Probably I'm going to mess myself up at some point here. But he, yeah, he's elite. Unbelievable numbers. Pablo Lopez, he's average, but like he's the top of average. He is quite amazing for the Marlins. Corbin Burns. What are his stats this year, by the way? Oh, wow. Oh, he's having, like, a great year. I think you kind of have to put him in elite, which that's not good. Okay, Brandon Woodruff is above average. I need to start flying through some of these. Joe Ryan, grand scheme of things, not there. Sonny Gray, same thing. DeGrom, ugh. We haven't seen him pitch in a while, and I know he is definitely one of the best five when he's healthy. For the sake of this list, don't get mad at me. We're going to put him in above average just because he hasn't played in a while. Scherzer, phenomenal. Is he better than... man, are you kidding me, dude? This is so tough. Yeah, the above average, I guess. Gerrit Cole, top of above average, apparently. Nestor, going to average. Having an unbelievable year, but it's one time. Montas, same thing, needs to stay healthy. Zach Wheeler, again, above average. He's so good, so close to elite. Aaron Nola, the same thing. Incredible strikeout numbers from him. Jose Quintana, average. Because his numbers actually are not phenomenal. They're like about a 4 ERA. Paul Blackburn, sorry I had to do this out of order. He's below average. Zach Thompson. Just not good. Joe Musgrove having an unbelievable year, above average. Yu Darvish, this year not great. Probably about average for this list. Maybe could go above average for the sake of this. Robbie Ray, I think he's having like a solid year. Cy Young last year, above average. Logan Gilbert, right now, he's young. He's really young, but he's average. Dave Sclafani this year has been not good at all when he's healthy. He's been injured. Average. Rodon's been great, above average. Flaherty, we need to see him be healthy, but he's average right now. Wainwright, same thing, just really, really old, but he's so serviceable. He's great. Glasnow, haven't seen him play in a while. Not below. McClanahan has been very good for the Rays. He's above average. Martin Perez, the same thing. Very, very good. I'm sorry, I had to really speed this up. John Gray, right now, below average. Kevin Gausman, above average. Very good. Brios has been very disappointing this year, so he's going to go below average. Strasburg, haven't seen him play in a while. He needs to stay healthy, and we need to scroll down. And Corbin, yeah, he's bad. All right, there is your list. I am done. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you did enjoy, remember to leave a like as well as subscribe. Go check out all the socials and everything linked in the description. With that being said, see you guys in the next one. Peace out, and have a blessed one.